Kuzuko is a big five reserve in the Eastern Cape, South Africa. There's an enormous amount of wildlife in this ecosystem. 200 years ago, there was wall-to-wall thicket over at least 6,000 hectares, and spekboom was the dominant plant. Unfortunately, after intensive goat farming for two centuries, the landscape is no longer suitable for all those animals. We have the wonderful privilege here in this Kuzuko project of bringing back a habitat that is going to support the African wildlife that has lived in this landscape for thousands and thousands of years. Spekboom is forming an above-ground dam for the vegetation. 60 to 70% water dominating the landscape, and that water is used by the plants in times of drought to grow throughout the year. Other unique features of spekboom are the extremely dense canopy that it forms, shading out the hot African sun. And so spekboom is basically the cooling equipment that keeps the organic matter in the system and enables the soil carbon to build up to an astounding level. Well, the more soil carbon you have, the better the water holding capacity of the soil. So when it does rain intensely, the topsoil is able to hold on to the water. You have tens of other shrubs and trees occurring here that wouldn't occur here if it wasn't for the spekboom.
Reforest'Action develops high quality afforestation and reforestation project on all five continents. We are involved throughout the entire project evaluation and development cycle. In the Kuzuko project, Reforest'Action intervenes as a funding partner, but our scope actually goes way beyond just raising funds. Kuzuko was designed back in 2014, but funds weren't secured at the time, so that the project couldn't start. In 2021, 2022, after a successful experience on a non-certified project, we decided to go further in our South African partnership and make the Kuzuko project happen. So at the end of 2022, everything was in place to start planting. In the preparation phases, it was important to understand the details of the activities planned in order to consolidate a strong project proposal. We relied on past academic research conducted by our partner to build robust carbon sequestration projections. And thanks to our project development experience, we have also been supporting in certification steps, especially for CCB validation that is currently underway. We contributed to update monitoring protocols, and now that the project is running, we follow up closely on all monitoring activities. We like to perform an extra layer of high-level quality assurance quality control on all project data. And finally, as a last example, we implemented a framework for financial reporting, which altogether contributes to transparent and credible reporting on the project.
Planting spekboom has a very positive effect on the soil conditions in particular. It increases infiltration rate once it's established, and it will have a very positive effect on the local scale hydrology of the area. And of course, it will sequester a lot of carbon dioxide. Spekboom is considered an ecosystem engineer in thicket. It has a very positive effect on the local scale biodiversity underneath the canopy. It lays down a lot of leaf litter, which is home for little insects, spiders, millipedes, centipedes, all sorts of worms and interesting beetles that come and make their homes under spekboom. Moving up the trophic levels into the larger species, you know, the birds, the reptiles, the mammals, we will be creating extra habitat for certain species that are threatened, vulnerable, rare, or endangered even. Additionally, Spekboom facilitates, through its little microclimate, the germination and establishment of several other thicket tree and shrub species. Other species will come back into the system, and it means that the carrying capacity increases in the landscape, and you get this habitat reconstruction. In the local communities in this area, there is a very high rate of unemployment. It averages over 60%. We have created thus far well over 300 jobs. So we feed and we house the workers for the project. We also are ensuring that people earn much more than the minimum wage in the area. Through the Reforest'Action project, money will be donated to the Kuzuko Foundation Trust, and it'll be spent very, very well at two local schools. Part of it will be spent on improving the infrastructure at the schools. These funds will also be used to buy educational materials such as books, computers, pencils and pens. Some of the funds will also be used to establish a biodiversity garden at the schools, and it'll hopefully teach people from a very young age the value of biodiversity and the value of a clean and beautiful environment.
Certification offers strong guarantees to corporates or investors willing to contribute to climate change mitigation. In particular, the level of requirement for impact demonstration is basically equivalent to expectations in academic research in terms of data representativity and in terms of traceability in calculations. The strength of a certified project like Kuzuko is also that all players, from local communities to investors, are directly incentivized towards environmental performance. Concretely, the more impact, the more return on investment for project funders, and the more benefits shared with other players. In practice, this translates into more efficiency in ecosystem restoration.